Hi, welcome back to GeeklyEDU Biology. In today's video, we're going to be talking about vesicles and vesicular transport. So the first question that we have to ask ourselves when talking about vesicular transport is, what is a vesicle? A vesicle is basically any self-contained structure holding a fluid or a gas within a lipid bilayer membrane. So a lipid bilayer is when we have our hydrophilic heads, which is water-loving heads, and then our hydrophobic tails in the middle, which are water-fearing or don't like water. And vesicles are really important for both storing and transporting materials such as proteins, enzymes, and hormones, both within and outside of cells. And they're really essential for all life. So for things like digestion, metabolism, and also sending signals in our brains and in our nervous systems. And vesicles are formed with the help of what's called coat proteins. So these are proteins on the outside of that lipid bilayer membrane, which help the vesicle self-form into this spherical round structure. There's multiple different types of vesicles that have different functions in our bodies. The first of which are transport vesicles, which basically are used to transport proteins and other molecules within the cell. And then we have lysosomes. Lysosomes carry digestive enzymes, so they basically break down molecules and can be thought of as kind of the recycling plant within the cell. Peroxisomes also, like lysosomes, contain digestive enzymes, and they're really important to help us break down molecules such as fatty acids and alcohol. Then we have extracellular vesicles. Extracellular just means outside of a cell. So these are vesicles that are outside of cells, and they're really important for cell communication and signaling to one another. Finally, we have secretory vesicles, and these are vesicles that aim to bring molecules from within the cell to outside of the cell. So this is really common in our neurons, so sending signals from one neuron to another. So there's certain organelles within our cells that are very important with regards to vesicle formation. And the first of which is the endoplasmic reticulum, or the ER. And this is a really membranous organelle. So you can see here it has a lot of these folds, and so the membrane is quite large. And it comes in two main types. We have the rough ER. We can see here with it's called the rough ER because we have all these little ribosomes on the membrane there. And so this synthesizes proteins. And then we have the smooth ER, which we can see here is smooth as we don't have the ribosomes on that membrane. And this is really important for synthesizing lipids as well as metabolizing carbohydrates. And these organelles are really important with regards to vesicles as they're synthesizing these molecules, and once they're synthesized, they have to be then transported, which makes them having to form multiple vesicles. The next kind of really important organelle with regards to vesicles is the Golgi apparatus. And so what the Golgi apparatus does is it takes the materials that were created in the ER and then further modifies them before they're actually ready for their function. And so the vesicles come from the ER and then it will move into our Golgi apparatus, which is shown here. And so it first forms with that's called the cis face. So this is the face closer to the nucleus. And then it will move through the Golgi apparatus, eventually going to the trans face, which is facing the outside of the cell. And then from there, it will go to another vesicle aim to either go outside the cell or will go to vesicles such as lysosomes. And finally, we have the third really important organelle or part of a cell that's important for vesicles, and that's the plasma membrane of the cell itself. And so once the proteins or enzymes that are created in organelles such as the ER and modified in the Golgi apparatus, a lot of them then have to leave the cell for further use. And so then the vesicles will actually bind to the plasma membrane, and then it will be excreted in a process called exocytosis. And if you want to learn more about this, you can find the video titled Endocytosis versus Exocytosis. So endocytosis is just vesicles coming into the cell, and exocytosis is molecules leaving the cell. That's the end of this video. I hope that you enjoyed it and you learned something. If you want to learn more about other biological topics, please subscribe for more.